Hi, everyone. Thanks for joining today for our bite-sized PD on teaching news and information literacy with the News Literacy Project. Some of you might know, some of you might not know, but I have been chosen as the Utah ambassador for the News Literacy Project. So today I just wanted to introduce the platform to you and let you know. So let's get started. Yes, I hit record. Here are norms today. Please ask any questions. Because I'm going to be demonstrating and showing, if you have any questions about the platform or if I need to slow down, just let me know. And go ahead and type it in the chat. Today, this is a little blurry, but today I really feel like the instructional priority we're working on is cognitive rigor. Because one of the main goals of the News Literacy Project is not to teach children what to think, but to teach children how to think for themselves and how to discover the truth in what they read online. So our learning intention today is to learn about the resources on the News Literacy Project so that you can teach news and information literacy with your students. You'll know you're successful when you can make an account on Newslet. You can access the lesson plan and resources. You can access Checkology and you can access Rumor Guard. And so I'm going to go through all four of those things. I don't have much in the way of slides today because it's demonstration, but here are all the links that you'll be able to access directly to get to these resources. They're all on the News Literacy Project, but Checkology and Rumor Guard also have their own websites as well, or their own links. So you can get to them from multiple ways. Okay, so let's get started. We're gonna go to newslit.org. And the first thing I wanna talk to you about with News Literacy Project is that this is a nonpartisan nonprofit. Its sole goal and purpose is to teach news and information literacy because freedom of speech, freedom of the press is a key component of our democracy. And it's with these things that we are able to help students become responsible consumers of news and information and media so that they can be fully engaged in a civic life. We know that to make responsible decisions as a citizen, we need to be able to discern fact from fiction in what's being presented to us. So when you first come in, you can just click in here, click for educators on this button, for educators at the top. And you don't have to create an account, but there are just things that you can access when you do. So if you come up to for educators, you can see educator tools. This is where you can get to Checkology. The SIF newsletter is amazing. I'm going to show you an example here in a minute. The library and professional learning, the forum, the ambassadors, our events, and the help center. So let's just click for educators, and it's going to take you to Newslet Nation. And I'm going to move my little window here so I can see my whole screen. But here you can watch a video. You can see all of the same things here, but you'll come down just a little bit and you'll see register. And you just need an email. So I'm going to sign in here real quick. And I'm going to use my thing, my password manager. And when you come in, you'll be able to interact with the forum, those sorts of things. But what I really want to show you are the educator tools down here. You can get to it in two ways. Down here on the left or under for educators, click educator tools. So I'm going to come down on the left-hand menu and you'll be able to see all of these things. So we're going to go over to Checkology in a second. There's a resource library. And recently I sent out to all the ELA teachers, 8 ways to Google like a pro. And this is where we got it. So you can look for lessons, classroom activities, those sorts of things. So I'm going to come over since I'm high school, and here's the lesson on the importance of local journalism. Here's a lesson on the vital role of First Amendment protections and free speech. Here's a guide and a lesson on manipulation and misinformation. This is an entire unit for that documentary. Let's click on Democracy's Watchdog. Once you click into a lesson, you can just download all of the resources right here. They give you a rationale. Here are the essential questions. Here are key terms and vocabulary. And then here's how it connects. And then you can download. So what I really like is connections with other resources. This is actually a lesson within Checkology itself. And so you can click here. It will open up the Checkology lesson, which is an interactive sort of like slide deck. Gives a little warning here because this is for high school.
Hi, I'm Wesley Lau. I report and write.
I'm going to scroll past this because it's meant to be student facing. So a student has to watch this entire video before they can
American democracy
move forward. And then it's an interactive website. And they'll scroll through these lessons. So I really like that they have within this the link to the actual Checkology, or you can download. You can download the lesson plan. You can do an active learning component, and then they have related resources. So let's come back into the educator tools. That's a resource library. The SIF newsletter is a weekly newsletter that they send. And one thing I love about it is very frequently they will give examples of misinformation. And I love this. Right before Thanksgiving, they had civil Thanksgiving conversations. It was the focus on news literacy. And so within the SIF newsletter, they have why people believe misinformation. They talk about the midterms and how are we going to handle the elections. And then just all of these links and resources ready for you. So, sorry, as soon as I stopped talking, somebody said, "That's awesome." And I'm like, "I know it is awesome." So I subscribe to the SIFT. I think it's a great resource. And then they have Newsroom to Classroom. It's a program where you can connect with local news reporters. Then they have professional learning. So if you want to teach yourself to learn more about news, information, and media literacy, they have that here. And Newslit camps. Informable is a free app that's like a game. So if you use apps in your classroom with students, it's a game to see if they can identify misdis and malinformation within real life examples that have been loaded into the app. Pretty fun. I got it approved, so it's on the Learn platform. And then they have a podcast. So one thing I want to show you is that the Newslit project just isn't for students or for teachers. They have tools for everyone. They have quizzes, tips, public awareness campaigns, those sorts of things. So now let's look specifically at Checkology. When you come into Checkology, getcheckology.org, I'll click on this link. It'll take you to this page. If you've created a news literacy account, you can sign in with that account. Oh, I did not save my email, so I'm going to save this real quick. What's kind of cool is that you can create a classroom and students can sign in and do lessons online. So if I'm looking at content and I know that I want to teach a lesson on the First Amendment, I can come in here and preview this lesson and scroll through the lesson.
I'm Sam Chaltain.
Where they can, I can see it all. And it has word balls and those sorts of things. If I'm like, yeah, I like that, then I can actually assign this to one of my classes. So, I mean, they just have so many lessons here available. They have practice and extend, evidence or not, misinformation quests. These are interactive games. I love this add or not exercise. This is really cool because it gives real life examples. And the kids say, yeah, that's an ad. And I'll tell them if they're right or not. Then if we go to the next one, here's a video.
Today on Dream Digs, we go inside a $7 million New York City loft that has a zip line, a full-size spiral slide, and more.
So they should see that this is an ad for a home insider, but let's say they're like, no, like this is, if a student's like, no, this is just looking at a normal family. So they're going to say not an ad. Oh, no, there it goes. It makes them, it waits a certain amount of time because they should have watched the whole video. And I was right. So, and then it gives a reason why. So you can preview lessons, come in, add a lesson, select a course. They have entire courses for your students and contests and messages. Like, they just have so many things here for you. Now I can come in and customize this course and change the name and those sorts of things. I can change my course here and say, no, like really, this is for English language arts. So I'm going to assign English language arts since that's what I teach in high school. And then my students, as they log in, they can go through this course. So they have this check center, which I think is super powerful because students can use this to check their own sources. So let's pretend I recently read, I saw on TikTok that Disney is going to tear down the Disney castle, right? I'm horrified because I love Disney. I can come in and do a quick check on the website. If my mouse is going to work, let me try this again. Okay. Oh, it's because I'm doing like clicking here and I need to do get started. Woo! Okay. So I have an image or a video with a claim. Great. Name this quick. I'm going to call it Disneyland Castle. I can upload an image or a screenshot. I don't really have one because it was a TikTok. And now that I can't access TikTok on here, I can't do that. So let me try again. Okay, so I'm back. I went and found the URL. So I'm going to come in here and paste. This is an image URL. But you can come in and click in here and click submit. And it will say, does the text make a checkable claim? One fact that is factual in nature and can be confirmed or debunked using outside sources. Okay. Yes, because when I Googled this, yes, I saw that it could. Did you originally find this claim on a site that allows users to post content directly? Such as, for example, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, or a message board. I found it on TikTok, which is the same thing. People can post on their own. So I'm going to say yes. Have other people used comments to provide conclusive evidence that this claim is false? I'm going to say, I don't know what they mean. You can click see an example. It will load an example. But I'm going to say that yes, people, I'm trying to think when I saw it in the comments, I didn't see any like conclusive evidence. So I'm going to say no. Open a new tab and search the central claim. So have any credible sources, organization, news organizations, either debunked or verified it. Oh, so what this is teaching me as a student is to read laterally. So I'm going to come in here. This was the search I did, and I'm going to change it to a question. Is the Disneyland castle going to be torn down? Let me do a search. Let's go back to the website. Well, okay. Disney food blog, Snopes. They're a great website, but they're not actual news organization. Sports, Distractify, Indie, Disney Fanatic, Disney Dining. Oh, Inside the Magic. That seems like a pretty, you know, Disney-centric site, maybe. TikTok claims Disney Cinderella's castle is being demolished. Fools, internet. And so, okay. It's still not a like reputable news organization. So I'm going to come up here and I'm going to type in news and see what comes up here. If I can find any news articles, like, or news organizations. Oh, no, that's Hurricane Ian. You know, I can't really find a new reputable news organization. So I'm going to come in here. No. Is the claim about the accompanying image or video? Yes. Using your observation skills in a reverse image search, can you verify whether the image or video is authentic? In other words, can you confirm that it actually depicts what the claim says it does, or it hasn't been taken from another context? Oh, okay. So that website or that link right here. Okay. Oh, it's restricted because it's on TikTok. It's interesting because it automatically gives me related content, right? Look, there's the picture. Well, I mean, it's just a picture of the castle. Really, it's just the words over the top. So I'm going to say it's being used in a deceptive manner. And so it tells me, yep, this is likely false. Probably shouldn't share this. So I think it's a great little tool because it helps walk kids through lateral reading and analyzing sources, which is a great thing. So the last thing we're going to talk about is RumorGuard. And this is a new site for the News Literacy Project. And really it is Snopes, but for kids. So their most recent one is this TikTok here. Are we seeing a trend? Or maybe this is Facebook or Instagram. And it says, when you hear the airports are finally ditching the liquids in hand luggage rule for 2024. So this is a positive video. As someone who travels, I really like this. So they're like, no, this is misleading. They haven't ditched the carry-on liquid bands yet. So you can come in here and learn more. And they'll go through and they'll do a quick look. Right. And it's kind of the same questions that you get in the quick check. Yeah, the Transportation Safety Administration has not announced any changes. Yes, there are a few international airports that are allowing travelers to have larger liquid carry-ons because they have these new high-tech 3D scanners. I recently flew through Long Beach Airport and they didn't make me take anything out of my bag because they had these new scanners. Yes, the UK's Department of Transportation expects to implement these scanners by 2024, but As of December 2022, the UK had made no changes. So here's the takeaway. Honest misunderstandings are commonly a common driver of falsehoods. They talk about how content creators with small followings will often create a video that could go viral. And an American audience missed the context that this was for the UK and assumed that this policy was for US airports as well. So this account, I love this because it says a follow-up video was shared by the same account. And you could click there and go there, but because of the district servers, I probably can't access it, so I won't click on it. And then it just is a really good reminder, like double check these claims. A quick search would have found this news report. Then you can go straight to the news report. So as a teacher, I could show this and then I could go, what do you guys think? And help them walk through this. So they go through the five factors to determine if a viral rumor is misleading or false. And they look at source, evidence, authenticity, context, and reasoning. But they couldn't find any sources. They couldn't find any evidence. And so they stopped. They're like, oh. And then it has here, learn how to check for sources, learn how to check for evidence. And you can click here and it will take you to additional Checkology resources and resources on Newslet. So everything's embedded. And I love this tutorial on lateral reading, 8 tips to Google like a pro. So if we come here to this lesson on lateral reading, we have this video that we can show our students.
Hey there, right, Checkology student.
That's embedded right in, and it's in Checkology as well. So the great thing about the News Literacy Project is because their goal is just to educate, they've made everything super accessible for teachers and easy to see. So to come back to the main page, create an account, explore around, look at the lessons, look at the resources. I really think that this resource library is amazing. And if you don't want to sign up for Checkology and create a lesson, you can come in and just access it from here. And you can project it with your students rather than having them do the lessons independently. But these infographic posters, like 8 tips to Google like a pro, the way I said that out, are free for you to download and give to your students, use in your classroom, post online. They're yours. So I hope this was helpful and that you look into the News Literacy Project, see all that they have to offer, because it is an incredible resource that's free and it is 100% nonpartisan. They will not post, retweet anything that they feel like is divisive to one party over another. And I really appreciate that I know that when I use their resources, it's not going to become a debate in my classroom. And yeah, so just as a reminder, the links are all in this slideshow. And don't forget, go to the Canyons U Bite Size PD page and sign up for your relicensure credit. If you have any questions, please reach out to me. I can help you with anything that you need, whether you're ELA or not.